tourists are like dentists. If they see a hole, they'll fill it, you know? And I think a great guitarist knows when not to play. He knows exactly when not to play, and that's what makes it tight, and that's what makes it dramatic.
A musician, you know? So they're looking more from probably the end we look at it, because you know? Sometimes you can be a bit clever with the music, and you know, then I think you're in a different, you're not in a rock and roll band, you're usually in a jazz band or something, more on musical ability.
Great band, you know, I've had no problem saying that, you know. We can play, we can rock, and that's what we do. I mean, we play, if you want to play other stuff, you go somewhere else and do it, you know. But here, it's the one thing is to hook onto the feel, hopefully have a nice sound on stage, and just do the damage, you know.
There's very few rock and roll bands. There's rock bands, there's sort of metal, there's whatever. But there's no rock and roll bands. There's the Stones in us. And their sound's completely different to us. So we really aim, you know, in an area that's going back in time with the sounds, still what the old analog sounds, you know. So we try to even keep that. And the sounds are bigger than digital. To entertain as well as good music in a live situation. Otherwise people can see it once and next time they, well, we saw it, we've got the record, who cares, you know. But AC/DC, some concerts can be, because of the what Angus does on the show on that night, or Brian, there's lots of, you know, it's just that performance, and they come in, well, something's going to happen on that stage tonight. They always know that, and that's what I think it is. that personality up the two up front, as well as a really good band and good writing and yeah. determined never to change what we do. It's just
determined
the whole
to never change it.
It's what we always wanted to do. So you don't go do something you've always wanted to do, and 25 years later you say, it's time for a change.
You had three different drummers, that must have been different.
Yeah, but we've always tried to get that emulating of Phil's style, because that's what the style of the band was. You know, it's the simpleness in the drumming. And that's what we'd aim for. A little bit of that swing. They didn't need to swing a bit, you know, that was... So that's what's required, but we always had ambitions of getting Phil back, you know. It was just a matter of time for Phil. He just needed a time out thing, you know, to get back to his own life and everything. But he said he wanted back, you know, and it was just waiting for the moment. And so we were just putting drummers in there, really, until we got him back, because he is the real sound with the rest of the guys. It's the real... deal, you know. It still sounded like AC/DC, but it just didn't have as much oomph under it.
They call me up again, and we go over and sit down after 12 years, and it's like I've been out five minutes for a cup of tea. It's like I've been out for a packet of cigarettes, and that is absolutely true. We sat down, never heard the song, you know, yeah, right, okay, this is it. And that's it, simple as that, you know. Because I love it. I love it. I love it, you know, and it comes out the right way. The guys like the way it comes out. You know, technically, I've got quite a few problems as a drummer, but when it gets going and you get some passion, then I have my own expertise with that, you know. So that's about the only way I can defend the way I play drums.
Books online here and there, a movie here and there. His lyrics were pretty, you know, as a lot of people know now, they're really like right up there with respect. You know, that guy's lyrics, I know eventually he'll be around for hundreds of years. Bond, if maybe he lived longer, he could have possibly gone on, you know, within that theme because of his cleverness, even. The way he wrote, it was rock and roll, it was about women, the rock and roll life, but he certainly had a way with those words, and I think he's already laid down, you know, that mark on, you know, in his years with the band, you know, it's stuff like I said, it'll be around for centuries. I think he's like Robbie Burns, you know, the Scottish poet, everything was like Robbie Burns, his uniqueness in his own way. And he came out of a period that he could come out today with those lyrics, and they'd be brilliant. You know what I mean? He was so good at it.
He's somewhat become a legend. That must have been very difficult for Brian in the early days.
Yeah, it still is occasionally for Brian. You know, that the question's still around. You know, yeah, but he's dealt with it. I'd say lesser men wouldn't be around if. But Brian handles it, you know, he's a tough guy, strong guy, you know, he won't take no for an answer when he knows he can do it, he knows he's got it in him, but sometimes it's hard for him, you know, if there's a bit of bad press on him, or if they compare, because it's so long ago, and like I say, he's been in the band three times longer than Bond was, it won't go away. Become a little blasé with it because we've played together so long that you tend, it's just there, we just don't even think about it, you know, it's just, we just help each other out really up there, you know what I mean, that's how we're playing, you know.
I still, you know, it's like we look at each other, you know, he knows what I bring to the table and I know what he brings, yeah, so, you know, I still look, to see, you know, like, I mean, even when I've worked with people, you know, good other people, even like Matt Lang, who's very prominent in the world of music as a producer and stuff. You know, even when he said to me, "That's a great piece of guitar there," you know, I had to ask, I say, I'm not worried what he says, I'm worried what Malcolm says, you know. So, you know, if Malcolm went, "Yeah, that's good," you know, then I knew that it was something there. Because he knows your talent better. He's worked with you all the years, and he knows when you're faking it and when you're really doing it.
And like I say, you forget, but when I listen back to some of the live stuff, you go, geez, because sometimes you don't hear everything Angus is doing solo-wise, and from the volume on stage, you may not pick it up, but when you listen back later, you know, you go, geez, he's playing really, how could he do that with all that racket behind him at the time, because you can't hear nothing, he's a hot player, you know, and I think there's a lot of people, again, his dues are yet to come, Angus. You know, they don't understand how good he really is on guitar. You know, there's some who do, but you know what I mean? One day they'll find out, you know, they'll see it in its entirety, you know, and go, fuck, he's been the best guitarist of them all. And that'll be true, you know. I mean, out of all these rock legends, so-called.